pending case. What we got from the RTC of Las Piñas is just temporary restraining order. Okay. So recently, a video with me on it has been circulating in the social media. I have this to say. I filed a case before the Regional Trier Court of Las Piñas because of the prohibition of the PFRB to accept our friendship sticker to pass through the roads of the BF Resort Village. And that is against a local legislation. And so I filed a case so that people can still use the friendship route. And we were given a TRO. They were given a TRO, so the BF Resort Village cannot anymore stop the people from using the friendship route. Siguro doon sila naghalit sa akin kasi that will bring down the income because they're charging 2,500 per sticker. Yung friendship sticker is free for Las Piñeros. So, since then, I have encountered problems involving the BFRB Homeowners Association, Inc. The first is that they are removing the signages na nag-i-indicate that BFRB Homeowners Association should honor the friendship sticker based on a local legislation passed in 1995. So siguro nagagalit sila, so tinatanggal nila. Siguro I have replaced that announcement in all the five entrances of BF Resort 4 times already. And so this last time, nakita na sila ang nagre-remove through the CCTV. And then I was building impounding or shelter facility for stray dogs and cats in the subdivision. They did not allow me to do so. Okay. And then recently they fence and block the access to my composting facility at the river easement along the road in BF Resort Village. That easement I got when I removed the ISF about 7 years ago. With the DPWH, we relocated them and gave them financial assistance. So I was able to build my composting facility. And they are fencing it. And they do not want me to build a sidewalk in front of the composting facility. They stop the entry of the ready mix bus to bring the ready mix to the sidewalk. And at the same time, they park their boom truck and L3 vehicle in my sidewalk so that I cannot pave my sidewalk, the sidewalk of the composting facility. And then they prohibited me from planting trees in the, in the easement area of that composting facility. And the last but not the least, when a homeowner association invited me to their fiesta celebration and they put a tarpaulin to welcome me, they remove it and they said it's against the rules. So I have already consulted my lawyers, instructed them to study the appropriate cases and actions in addition to the complaint which they granted me a TRO. So, just for you, I don't want people to remember me as a senator who just keep quiet. I want to be remembered as someone who will fight for what is right and what is good for the people. That's all.
So, ma'am, can you tell me about malicious intent doon sa pag-post?
Yes, but I don't want to talk about it because we're going to court. So that's sub judice.
your initial reaction upon being viral.
Yeah, I was talking to them to remove the gate because that composting facility is for the public. and they don't want to. They're arguing with me, but I guess they have plenty of security guards, and I'm alone.
I'm sorry. You have plans of charging the person who took the video and posted it on the social media, or wala naman po?
I'm consulting my lawyer.
Pero identify mo lang?
Yes, of course. Yeah. We have been there for a long time. We were sitting and waiting.
So yung nakuha na lang yung outburst, hindi yung long...
Wala namang outburst. Walang outburst. They're just inventing that. There's no outburst. I was just telling them to remove the gate because it's for public use. It's not for me. I don't need that, you know. It's my composting program has been there for 20 years, and it has been given award by an international agency, the Energy Globe Award, given by Austria, and the ambassador of Austria came to Las Piñas to give the award.
Ma'am, tama ba? Hindi ko kayo makadaan papunta sa composting area dahil
nila? Lalagyan nila ng gate. I just was wondering why doon naman sa composting area ko lalagyan ng gate.
So, contrary sa report yung outburst, walang gano'n. Ma'am, sorry. How will you address yung mga reklamo ng LGBT community when you said, hindi ko sasaktan yan, bakla pa yan?
Eh, ang laki-laki niya eh. Para masaktan ko siya. There's something wrong with him. He's a security guard. He has a gun in his holster. Oh, ano sasabihin ko? Masasaktan ko ba yan? Ang tapang ko naman, laki-laki niyan, liit-liit ko, tapos wala akong baril, siya may baril. Why will I do it?
Kung yun isa po kasi yung nakikipag-usap sa inyo, yun ang paulit-ulit na nagsasabi ko, sasaktan
niyo. Inire-record niya pala eh. Nagtataka nga ako sa kanya, why is he saying that over and over again? And yun pala nire-record niya.
Sino po yung official?
Wag na lang kasi I'm filing a case.
So after that incident, may halang pa rin ngayon o tinanggal na po
nila? Meron pa din pero binuksan ang gate, di ba? Dati sarado. Ngayon bukas na. Bukas ba? I haven't been there. I don't want to go there na.
Pero dapat po bukas because of the DRO that...
No, this is a composting facility at may mga nakatira doon. In addition, mine is in the easement of the river. So why will you close a composting facility? Where will we bring our kitchen and garden waste? Diba? And there are homeowners there also on the other side. My composting facility is beside the river. It's in the easement of the river.
So ma'am, yung DRO parang... one step.
Yeah, yun sa main road yun. Oh, they're not allowed to stop the use of the friendship route anymore. That's the TRO.
Ma'am, ilan na-apektado na yung daily na... Kasi di ba kaya pinapusan, kaya may friendly sticker para friendship sticker?
All the Las Piñeros who will pass that way, thousands yun. That's a friendship sticker kasi a friendship route kasi nung 1995 sobra traffic sa Sapote Alabang Road, so we interconnected the main roads of the subdivision so that the homeowners and the Las Piñeros with a friendship sticker, which is free from the local government, can pass through and go to Alabang and to Sapote without passing through the Sapote Alabang Road. That's the use of the friendship sticker because the Sapote Alabang Road cannot accommodate all of us. It's difficult.
So
thousands yan eh. Oh. Kasi there are 600,000 people in Las Piñas. On the average of 4 a house or 5, that's 120,000 homes affected.
And of course, marami rin nagko-complain sa inyo dahil hindi yeah. in-honor.
Hindi nila in-honor. They cannot do that because it is local legislation. You cannot disobey the law. Diba?
That's wala pang power yung local government na persahin sila sa ginagawa.
I don't want to comment on the local government. I just know my right. So I exercise my right.
So wala ginawa yung PRG?
I told them that I will file a case.
So what will happen to your yung pet project? Yung dogs and cats and...
What?
Well, kasi diba yung sabi mo ka, nakabangan doon yung mga project
mo. Mm. Oh, they opened. Natakot yata they opened also. But they intended to do something not good. So I have to ako nagko-complain lang ako para wag nila continuously gagawin to because it's not good for the people. Me, I can always do what is good for me, but it's not good for the ordinary people. Yeah, I'm a member. I think I longest running homeowner ako. I was there in 1977 or 45 years ago. I'm a 45 years homeowner of BF Resort Village, and it's only now that this is happening. Walang explanation. They just want to do it.
So, ano ko sa yung presidente
ng Oh.
Ano siya nag-justify mo?
Hindi siya nag-justify. Basta he wants to do it, he will do it.
Ano ba't ganun karakas niya?
Ayaw ko sa kanya. Because maybe nothing to lose.
Bakit nag-file kayo ng case doon sa homeowners o officers na nag-decide na maglagay ng harap?
Not yet. Pero yung pinal kong case for the friendship route, yung ayaw nilang papasukin yung may mga friendship sticker na Las Piñeros who are entitled to pass through the road based on a local legislation. That's the case I filed before. That's why naiinis siguro sila sa akin kasi I stopped them. But they have been doing bad things after that to me. And I...
Mama, kinasuhan nyo lang yung owners?
Yes, because they were the ones who... Yeah, yeah.
You're not leaving the subdivision,
huh? Hana?
You're not leaving the subdivision.
No, I have been there for 45 years. Yeah. That's owned by BF Homes.
Pwede ko pag-clarify lang kung kailan ito nangyari?
Yung alin? Kailan yon? I for anong date?
Monday last
week.
That day mo na nangyari nung
The next day. Nagtataka nga ako siya, sabi siya nang sabi na wag mo saktan. Sino na nanakit? Yung pala nire-record niya at ibabiral niya. Bad intent.
Ma'am, kahit ginagano kayo to, bakit pa rin pa kayo monthly
uses? Usually, I pay the whole year. Hindi naman ako nagma-monthly.
Sumabayad na kayo for this
year?
Hindi pa.
So, mag-asin yung consultation with your lawyer? Wala pa siya clinical advice kung
meron na.
Kasuhan.
Oh, pero that's confidential.
I'm sorry, yun pong nagsasabi na huwag yung kasaktan yung mga guard namin. Is an officer of the whole.
Siya ang presidente.
Pero ma'am, first time yung encounter na yun?
Hindi. Before, ayaw niya papasukin yung amin truck na may dalang, ano tawag doon, yung cement ready mix para i-pave yung sidewalk. Tinawag ko yung chief of police ang nagpapasok. Kasi, what's wrong with paving the sidewalk for free, ha? Ako magbabayad, oh. Ba't siya nagagalit? Sabi ko, kung gusto mo... May sidewalk ka, di magawa ka ng sarili mong sidewalk and I will build my own sidewalk para masaya lahat tayo, di ba? Marami tayong sidewalk, di ba?
So, parang prepared sila dun sa incident na yun.
Do you think tinap kayo dun sa idea eh?
Ano?
Did you feel you were trapped so that you will become on cam, you will go viral?
I don't do that. I don't do that. So I never do that. Kaya okay lang sa akin kasi hindi naman ako known for that.
I mean the owners. Oh,
they planned it, but that's okay with me. Alam mo, pag ikaw public official, you encounter all these problems and you must accept it because that's the price you pay for being a public official. You have to accept all these things. So you just do what you have to do afterwards, di ba?
So hindi naka-discourage?
Kung siya hindi natatakot, ako pa. No, I will go to court.
Other issue.
Yes.
Pagkakaroon ng El Nino, and then may mga pangamba na magkaroon ng shortage sa supply ng bigas, ng gulay. So as chairman committee on agriculture, do you think may ginagawang preparations yung government?
Yung na-appoint ngayong NIA administrator was a former mayor who did a very good model in Pidig, Ilocos Norte. And he was telling me that what he did there, he can do. Kasi ang ano niya is water impounding facility. Oh. And that's a very practical solution. Na pag rainy season, ipunin mo yung tubig, tapos yun ang gagamitin mo pag dry season. And he was very successful in that. So I think he can do a project ng NIA, sa NIA na will soften the blow of the El Nino. Kasi two cropping season naman yan eh. May dry season at may rainy season. So I think he can strategize on that. Kasi na-experience niya to sa bayan niya and he was able to solve it. So maybe he can do it all over the Philippines. He was telling me about that.
Pero kung ngayon, di ba bihira ang ulan?
So, yeah. May sinasabi siya na yung water sa ocean or sa mga river, may practical sinasabi siya sa akin na you just have to build a way by which the water will go to the farms. So, na total ginagawan din ng, nag-ini-improve din ng DPWH yung rivers. So, you just have to do it in a way that it will go to the farms para water for the farms.
So, plano pa lang yun, ma'am? Kasi mag-start na yung
I think they're going to do it. So, I hope that, kasi we always meet this problem. And besides, yung ating rice tariffication law, kung mag-import man sila, towards the long term, it's good for the farmer. Kasi yung RTL natin created the Rice Competitiveness Enhancement Fund. And that Rice Competitiveness Enhancement Fund answered two problems pointed out by the PDIs, Philippine, yung research, yung gumawa ng research comparing Vietnam and Philippines in terms of cost of production. Kasi Vietnam produces palay at 6 pesos per kilo and the Philippines 12 pesos per kilo, 12.50. And they pointed out that the 6 peso difference, 3.50 is labor and 2.50 is the productivity of the farm. So nakita natin na ang secret para bumaba ang labor is mechanization, di ba? And then para tumaas ang productivity ng farms is better seeds. So that was tackled by it's a PDIS study, Philippine Institute of Development Study, PIDS. And we answered that in our Rice Competitiveness Enhancement Fund. We provided 5 billion for mechanization, 3 billion for distribution of inbred seeds from field rice that is made in the Philippines, and being taught now to the farmers para kumawala na yung Rice Competitiveness Enhancement Fund, they can produce their own seeds. So that will tackle the 6 peso difference, and we provided for training. Kasi syempre, kahit ka magbigay ng machine, magbigay ka ng seeds, kung hindi mo sila ite-train how to use them and how to maintain them, then may problema ka. So we provided 1 billion for training, distributed among TESDA, PhilMEC, PhilRice, and Agricultural Training Institute. And in addition, yung excess ng tariff on rice will go as financial assistance to farmers owning 2 hectares and below, which is 1.6 million farmers. So, iyon yung rice tariffication law. So, kahit sila mag-import, babalik lang lahat yung tariff sa small farmers.
So, huwag na pupunta nga po ba sa small farmers yung...
I am doing oversight on that. Kasi ang pagbibigyan ng machine, hindi naman individual farmers, yung kanilang co-op or association, kasi mahal ang machine. It cannot be used by a farmer owning 2 hectares. But the seeds, they distribute to the farmers. They have a list. Meron silang official list of rice farmers na pagbibigyan.
So, mabula kayo nakikita na ganun? Pwede mo yan,
siguro magkakaproblema, pero kung magkaproblema at hindi natin ma-reach yung ating target, then mag-i-import, yung proceeds ng tariff on imports babalik din sa farmers. So, yun ang makakatulong din sa kanila para later on, they will be cost-effective and may financial assistance pa din sa kanila doon. So, magandang model.
So, Mr. Chairman, nag-media ng agriculture and food, may tanong bakit pa daw niyang briefing para makita kung gaano tayo ka-prepared?
Oh, anytime. Oh, yeah. If someone from the Senate will file a resolution, then I'll call a meeting.
Kasi mo nagkaroon recently po, meron mga panawagan na i-suspend or repeal yung rice tariff.
Hindi kasi nila naintindihan eh. Alam mo, yung RTL, nagtataka ako sa kanila, ba't ayaw nila yun? Lahat ibibigay sa small farmer, di ba? In terms of mechanization, in terms of better seeds, in terms, at saka yung seeds na yun, pinoproduce ng cooperative of rice farmer in Central Luzon. E samantala yung hybrid seedling ng National Rice Program, binibili yun sa abroad eh. Ito hindi to imported at mura. At nagbibigay ng hanap buhay sa fellow farmers nila. Kasi those who can produce the seeds are producing it and supplying it to field rice. O di, nakakatulong pa sa hanap buhay sa Pilipinas, di ba?
Mag-assessment ba kayo kung gaano ito po nakatulong yung rice tariffication sa farmers?
Yes. May nagsasabi sa akin na ang dati cost nila 1250, may bumaba na ng 750. Yung magagaling, yung nauna na. Pero yung mga nahuli, sabi ng PhilRice, ang production daw nila before the Rice Competitiveness Enhancement Fund, ang production average ng farm per hectare is 3.7, ngayon 4.4. They expect that in 2024, it will be 5 metric tons per hectare. And if I continue, extend the rice tariffication law, kaya nilang abutin yung 6 metric tons per hectare, which is the aim. Pag kasi nag 6 metric tons per hectare, competitive na tayo sa Vietnam. May target naman sila eh.
Meron kayong bill supposed to be creating special courts for Spanish?
Yeah, that's why we're hearing it on Friday, kaya lang daw kayo, so nag-uusap kami ni Tol, Senator Tol, kung kailan namin pwedeng i-postpone. Kasi hindi naman kailangan kami i-write up doon. We just want to do the first hearing para madala namin sa technical working group para hindi masyadong delayed, di ba? Yun ang common time namin. is tumawag siya kanina, maghahanap uli kami ng common time para makapunta kayo sa Tanay. Kasi nga April, ano yung Friday, April, that's the last time. May 1 kasi holiday eh. Ang next, pwedeng hearing, May 1, holiday. So May 2 ang unang pwede, kung pwede siya. Kasi alam nyo naman si Senator Tolre, election is very busy. Ako, I can come anytime.
Ma'am, ano basically yung salient points?
Hindi, kasi merong naglalakad ako, may lumapit sa akin, hindi ko kakilala, Justice of the Court of Appeals. Ang advice niya sa akin, to create a special court for smuggling and cartel. Because if you bring the case to the RTC, dami-dami daw kaso daw, matatabunan lang yon. Unlike if there is a special court, yun lang ang ginagawa nila, then maaasikaso. Kasi nagtataka kami, I passed that anti-smuggling law in 2016. Nababasa ko naman sa dyaryo kasi may limit yun eh. 1 million for other agricultural products, 10 million for rice. Lahat naman na nakukuha nila, more than 10 million for rice and 1 million for agriculture. Walang na demanda at walang nakulong. Kasi doon, pag economic sabotage, non-bailable yon. Pending the hearing of the case, nakakulong ka. Eh, wala tayong nakitang nakulong, di ba? So,
ang covered nung bill nyo ba on smuggling is agri products?
Yes.
Other products?
No. Kasi hindi ba, we have to agree on that. Mawala ng lahat, wag mawawala ang food. So we really have to take care of agriculture. Kayo, mabubuhay ba kayo nung walang pagkain? Diba?
Oo. So kapag nagkaroon na ng anti-agricultural smuggling, in-expect na meron na talagang masasama?
Oo, yun lang ang gagawin mo. Tapos wala kang performance, halatang halata. Diba? Oo. Eh, sila na rin ang nagsuggest eh. Court of Appeals judge ang nagsuggest sa akin noon.
So mga ilang court ma'am under that?
Hindi. Depende siguro sa number of cases. Kasi dalawa yon, you either i-legislate or i-appoint na lang ng Justice of the Supreme Court. Siya mag-create ng law. Dalawang choices yun.
So, parang kagaya doon sa women and children?
Yes. Parang ganun.
So, once na ma-approve yun, magkaroon na ng Peru Court, yung mga pending case, doon na.
Ma'am, your comment po dun sa pagbebenta ng smuggled sugar sa mga kaliwas stores this May, by 85 pesos daw po. Tingin niyo, kasi may mga nagsasabi na parang nire-rewardan daw yung mga smugglers pa dahil binibenta pa sa kaliwa yun.
Pero hindi ba pag na-seize ka na smuggle sa government na yon? Hindi naman binabalik yun doon sa nag-smuggle eh. Confiscated na yun. Parang ari na ng gobyerno yun. Either siliban ng gobyerno yun or ipagbili sa kadiwa store. Pero hindi nababalik sa smuggler yun. Bawal yun. Di ba?
Dapat ba ganun or dapat mas mababa?
Eh, policy na nila yun eh. Oh. Pero ang proceeds naman nun will go to the government. Pag smuggled kasi, confiscated na yun. Government property na yun.
Concern nyo rin, di ba yung mga OFW, meron yung foundation. So yung sa sequestro ng mga OFW sa Sudan,
yeah.
Yung tutugunan, nagubiyan na yun.
Sabi nila, iuwi nila lahat eh, di ba? May naiuwi na, di ba? I think they will bring them home kasi popular na cause yan. I mean, I'll be surprised if they don't. Oo. At saka meron na tayong Department of Migrant Workers. Yun naman lang ang trabaho nila talaga, to take care of the OFWs. I think they will do it.
Is it like yung Korea, parang may chartered flight?
Hindi ba? Pwede naman din tayo mag-chartered flight.
Dapat yung parang
solution. Oh, kasi I don't think may flight tayo to Sudan. May flight ba ang Philippines to Sudan? I don't think so. I think they will bring it home. Yeah, by chartered flight. Otherwise, pupunta ka sa ibang lugar na may aeroplano, tapos dun ka uuwi. That can be done also, but they have to transfer them to a place where they can ano, they can take the plane going home to the Philippines. Okay na. Salamat.